Hello friends, in this video let's quickly talk about what is a row number in Postgres and what is the purpose of it and how to work with a row number. This is one of the inbuilt function in Postgres which really helps developers to identify the unique rows or rank of each row in a particular table. See, there are cases where you may not get a unique ID to each and every row. So that time you need to generate a runtime number to each and every record. You can generate a unique number to each row based on certain categories, certain scenarios. So let us say like so you have a 10 records, let's take 10 records. If you take, you have 10 records, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. Okay, unfortunately there is no unique key defined for each row, so that time I need to define a number to each and every record. So that time I am going to identify on what basis I need to generate a unique ID for this row. So based on that scenario, I'll generate a row number for each every record. So this record has been identified as a row number as 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like this. Each and every record gets a unique number. If two rows has the same values, still yes, one row gets 1 and second row the other value gets 2, row number. So now you need to identify, so out of 1 and 2, 1 is duplicate. So there are multiple cases and multiple scenarios are there, we'll go for it. So to explain this row number, I designed a basic table with the name of employee. So if you see this table, which are having 6 columns and around some 17 records. If you see employee ID, see this table has employee ID as a unique record, but I'm talking about in general case. If you do not have, better to use a row number in runtime. Employee name and location and department ID and salary and manager ID. Now I want to generate a unique record or unique rank to each and every record based on the salary. See, this employee ID is generated based on the joining dates, but this rank which I am going to generate, that is based on their salary. The person who has highest rank, okay, so that might be the highest salary in a table. So the people who has a least rank, that might be them, the person who has the least salary. First of all, what is the syntax here? So if you see the syntax here, so syntax is row number, row number over. So here you need to use partition class, partition by. So this is optional class. So columns you need to specify on what basis you want to do it. Next, order by. Order by is mandatory. Okay, columns. So that's it. This is the syntax of it. Now let me apply the same syntax to the employee table here. Okay, so let me quickly, instead of star, let me put what are the columns I need. I need EMP name, okay, comma, location. Just for time being, I'm keeping location. I'll use that location in the second scenario. Next, salary. So if I run this, obviously I'll get 3 columns in the output. Let me quickly run it. Yes, I got 3. Now, so here I want to generate a row number for each and every record. Okay, so similar way, I'll apply here. Row number, okay, over, yeah. So first, as I mentioned, partition by is optional, so I'm going to use only order by for time being. Order by salary descending. Okay, so I want to generate a row number based on descending the salary. Now, so let me make it as a row number here, okay. Alias, I'm giving as RM score number. Let's quickly run this. If you run this, now if you see here, So the person who has highest salary has a first row number, the person who has a second salary has a second number, the people who has a same salary, let's go for that case, yes, the people who has the same salary, one person got 9th rank, the different person got 10th rank, okay. So now again similar way, so this person got 15th rank and one more person, Raj got 15th and John Williams got 16th rank. So now, so this I applied a row number on the whole table. Okay, so that is the reason why I have a duplicate salaries. But if you see, if you take this in USA and UK, okay, I have a duplicate. Okay, so if I take a partition, then so this guy get a one rank and this guy get a different rank because I'm going to partition the data based on the location. So let me quickly show you how to apply that as well. Select EMP name, comma location, similarly, comma salary, similarly I'll apply the same, row number of over partition by location, order by sal DSC. So I'm going to make it as R underscore number from EMP. Okay, so let me quickly run this record. Yeah, so let me here I missed the comma. Okay, let me quickly run this. Yeah. Now if you see here the output, so all the India records. Look, records are segregated based on the location. Now, out of India, like I have around eight people got the rank, and first person who has highest salary in India got the first rank, and the person who has the least rank got the eighth rank. The similar way, if you go to the different location, UK here, so the people who has highest salary in UK got the first rank, the people who has the least salary as 2500, that is fourth rank. In a similar way, USA also. So now the ranks or row numbers has been generated based on the location. See, if you see overall result, multiple people got a rank once, but different locations. If you see the previous example, every record has their own unique number. This record, this scenario, so records are partitioned or segregated based on the location. So now you need to decide what scenario is suitable for us. So now in this case, the people who has the like if you want to identify location wise top salaries, UK has 4000 and USA has 4500 and India has 4150. Otherwise, let me quickly apply this. So let me apply a subquery, select star from here game where r underscore no equal to 1. So let me quickly run this query. Now if you see here, so I got the people who has highest salary based on the location. If you see here, okay, so the people who has the least salary we can identify in a different way. The people who has highest salary we can easily identify by writing a subquery like this, but there is a different way as well. We can even identify that, but this is one way of identifying it. So that's all about it. If you have any questions, please drop a question in your comment section. That's it.